Pelvic inflammatory disease. What to know? Pelvic inflammatory disease is an inflammation of the female reproductive organs. It can lead to scar formations with fibrous bands that form between tissues and organs. It can affect the uterus or womb, the fallopian tubes, the ovaries, or a combination. Complications include chronic persistent pelvic pain, ectopic pregnancy, and infertility. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, 1 in 8 women who have had pelvic inflammatory disease or PID have difficulty becoming pregnant. Most cases result from an untreated infection in the vagina or cervix that spreads. Sexually transmitted infections or STIs are a common cause, but it can develop from infections due to other causes. Around 8 lakh women receive a diagnosis of pelvic inflammatory disease each year in the United States. Symptoms. Many women with pelvic inflammatory disease have no symptoms. If symptoms appear, they can vary from mild to severe. However, untreated pelvic inflammatory disease can have serious consequences. Possible symptoms include pain, possibly severe, especially in the pelvic area, fever, fatigue, bleeding or spotting between periods, irregular menstruation, pain in the lower back and the rectum, pain during sexual intercourse, unusual vaginal discharge, frequent urination, vomiting. Sometimes the symptoms resemble those of an ovarian cyst, appendicitis, endometriosis, or a urinary tract infection or UTI. Pelvic inflammatory disease can be acute, lasting up to 30 days, or chronic if it lasts more than 30 days. One difficulty with treating pelvic inflammatory disease is that the symptoms are varied and that some women may have no symptoms. Anyone who experiences symptoms or who thinks they may have been exposed to an STI or other cause of infection should see a doctor. Complications. Complications that can arise if pelvic inflammatory disease is not treated include scarring that can lead to fertility problems, recurring pelvic inflammatory disease, severe pelvic pain, a tubo-ovarian abscess. Many women do not realize they have had a pelvic inflammatory disease until they seek medical advice for infertility problems. A woman who has had pelvic inflammatory disease has a 20% chance of infertility due to scarring of the fallopian tubes and a 9% risk of a future ectopic pregnancy. The odds of developing chronic pelvic pain are 18%. Causes. Pelvic inflammatory disease usually starts with an infection that begins in the vagina and spreads to the cervix. It can then move to the fallopian tubes and the ovaries. The cause of infection can be bacterial, fungal, or parasitic, but it is more likely to involve one or more types of bacteria. Sexually transmitted bacteria are the most common cause of pelvic inflammatory disease. Chlamydia is the most common, followed by gonorrhea. The American Family Physician, or AFP, estimates that between 80-90% of women with chlamydia and 10% of those with gonorrhea have no symptoms. Some 10-15% of women with chlamydia or gonorrhea go on to develop pelvic inflammatory disease as a secondary infection. Who is most likely to be affected? Women are more likely to develop pelvic inflammatory disease if they are sexually active and under 25 years of age, have several sexual partners, Do not use barrier contraceptives. Use a douche. It is most common among women aged 15 to 29 years. Diagnosis. A physician will ask about symptoms and carry out a pelvic exam to check for tenderness. They will also test for chlamydia and gonorrhea. A swab may be taken from the cervix and maybe from the urethra, the tube from the bladder through which urine flows. There may be blood and urine tests. An ultrasound scan may be used to check for inflammation in the fallopian tubes. Sometimes a laparoscope is used to view the area. If necessary, tissue samples can be taken through it. Prevention. Pelvic inflammatory disease can become a serious condition, but there are some ways to minimize the risk. Having regular screening, especially for those who have multiple sex partners, ensuring sexual partners are tested for infections and STIs. Not douching, because this increases the risk. Using a condom or cervical cap and practicing safe sex. Not having sex too soon after childbirth or a termination or loss of pregnancy. Sex should not resume until the cervix closes properly.